is Lama Jigme Gyatso. I'm non-sectarian Buddhist monk, teacher, healer, yogi, and tantrika. Welcome to Enlightened Fitness, where first we will cultivate the body of a tantric sex god. Then we'll cultivate both the heart and the mind of a Buddha. Now, below this video, there's a tab that reads About. Click that. Below that, you'll see another tab that reads Show More. That'll reveal a whole list of links and tools to help you out. Today is our planking workshop. I'm going to start off with a complete set of planking exercises from the rank amateur to the seasoned veteran. So let's start in right now. The goal of this planking is to work the entire core as well as the cardiovascular system. Obviously, it's going to be more cardiovascularly taxing for the more advanced moves than the beginning moves. But that's what we're working towards. And of course, you can see my lovely crock pots and lentils on the camera. Okay, that should, looks like it's covering everything on the mat. And by mat, I mean yoga blanket. So the first thing I want to do is, just as I showed you how to do knee push-ups, we're going to start off with knee planks, which are not terribly challenging, but they're a good place to begin. Once you're comfortable with knee planks, move into full leg planks. We can do them on the elbows, but I prefer to do them on the hands, because that way we have the option to do what I like to call a moving plank. And this is definitely more cardiovascular than a static plank. The next move emphasizes the internal and external obliques as well as the overall core. Left knee to left tricep, back down, right knee to right tricep. So if you wanted to, you could do 10 on each side, and then 10 on the other side. But if what you really want is a challenging cardiovascular workout, alternate. In a sprint-like fashion. Now, that is not a dignified move, but it is profoundly effective for your heart, for your lungs, for your entire core. This will definitely sculpt the abdomen you're looking for. So now that we have a whole palette of exercises to choose from, let's do our 8-minute interval workout. So, of course, I'm using a smartphone here of a very generous patron. And we begin. Ah, what sweet sound. Yay. If you do it right and your breaks are short enough, you should be out of breath. I'm going to take a moment to move the camera. So half my head is missing, just like Lucy Liu and Kill Bill. There's no compromise with this thing. What's going on? There you go. That's gonna be better. Yeah, that's much better. That'll do. Oh look, there's our one. So I invite you to sit using the sitting instruction video, whose link is below. Now, if you're new to meditation, especially if you're new to meditation on the two bodhicittas, come on camera, focus, focus camera. Come on, I've got a bad case of the blurries. Come on camera. Gosh, come on you bastard. Okay, so this is your first opportunity to meditate on the two bodhicittas, the essence of love, may all beings benefit, O mani padme hum, by the essence of wisdom, O mani padme hum, completely letting go. I want to direct you to watch the instructional videos, the Love and Letting Go series. Start with number one. And work your way across the series, and we'll tell you all you need to know. This is non-instructional. This is participatory. So let's sit, and now let's meditate. There are videos on how to meditate, videos on how to sit, and videos on how to count the creases of your hands and your knuckles. So make full use of all the materials available for you. First three breaths, may all beings benefit. Out breath, all money of Meho. It's all silence. In breath, we smile. Out breath, relax. Now we count on our right ring finger. Om Mani Padme Hum, completely letting go. Our concentration, our samadhi, is the in-breath. Our contemplation, our vipassana, is the out-breath. Our background awareness, or sati, is aware of what thought, or memory, or fantasy, or emotion, or sensation is doing cartwheels in the background of our mind. We do not indulge it, we do not suppress it. We allow it to feed our practice of love and letting go. And we continue. May all beings benefit from any of the mayhem. As we continue our right index finger, Om Mani Padme Hum, completely letting go. We continue alternating three breaths of one exercise, three breaths of the other. Don't worry, this is written down for you in the practice materials below the video. You can take a deep breath. Open your eyes. And that concludes today's 49-minute silent meditation. Let's place our hands behind our back and open everything up and twist it over. Let's reverse. Hands in front. Oops, almost knocked over the water. Hands overhead. Let's bend to the right. And that's the left. Back to the center. Let's work our way into cat-cow. Actually, let's work our way into child's pose. Let's use our arms to straighten up. My on camera? Close enough. Let's bring our hands to our heart and twist to the left and twist to the right. Back to the center, relax the shoulders, twist to the left. Back to the center. Now let's do count down. Let's stand up. Let's do 12-phase Zen salutation. I'm not sure if I'm going to be on camera for this. Let's find out. I'm going to start doing it over here. It might look better. Let's conclude by the final verbal recitations. Let's recite the essence of the Bodhisattva vow of love. May I dedicate all my virtuous deeds to the universal well-being of all and strive to benefit others as much as I am able. Let's conclude with the universal prayer. Through my virtuous merit from practicing with pure motivation, may all living beings throughout all their lives continually experience the presence of Lama Jigme and always come under his care. Bye-bye.